Hi guys, Codetutor here,
and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In this particular video, I want to talk about services in Android. Services are one of the most very important concepts in Android. It is one of the four major components of Android, other being the activity, broadcast receiver, and the content provider. Services are used to perform long-running tasks in the background. When I say long-running tasks, it could be something like downloading a very large file in the background. And services don't have the UI because obviously you don't want to keep the user busy by showing download progress continuously. So services run without UI. The important word here is background. So services implementation, basically we will be talking about how to implement a service, how to start a service, how do I stop a service. When I say it runs in the background, does it actually run in the background on a separate thread? So without much further ado, let me get into a demo. I will reuse the code that I have been using in some of my other previous videos. You can see that I have two buttons here, start service and stop service. On click of this particular button, I want to start a service. So for that, first of all, I have to create a service. Let me create a new class. Let me call it as my service. To create a service, this particular Java class should extend a service class. So extends service class. As you extend a class, you have to override certain methods. So the first method is onStart command, and then onBind, then you have onDestroy, then also you have onStart command. As you can see, the onStart method is deprecated, so we will just remove this. The most important methods are these three. The onStart command is the method that gets executed whenever you start a service. How do I start this particular service? So let me start the service on click of this particular start service button. For that, I have to create an intent to start a service. Android recommends always using explicit intent. So let me create a intent here, private intent service intent. This service intent needs to be initialized. So service intent is equal to new intent. The first parameter is the context. You can say get application context, and second parameter is the service. So my service dot class. And another important thing is service that you have created needs to be declared in the manifest file. So let me open the manifest file, my service. Now, how do I start the service? For that, on click of this particular button, let me call a method start service. I have to pass the intent, that is service intent. And another thing is you cannot stop a service. There is no explicit way of stopping a service. Once the service is started, the lifecycle of the service has to be managed in the service itself. What we can do is in the service, inside the onStart command, you can do something like stop self. That will basically stop the service. Before stop self, you can write any task here which you want to do in the service. Right now, what I will do is I will just only write a log statement which will log as soon as this particular method is started or service is started. Log.i. I am using a constant string. In this case, I have a service demo, which is a constant. I will use that as a tag string. And what I want to display here is, I want to display the thread ID of the service. So in onStart command thread ID, for that I need to get thread dot current thread dot get ID. And in the main activity also, I am displaying the thread ID. Now let us try to understand whether when I start a service, it runs on a separate thread. If it runs on the separate thread, this thread ID that I am displaying here in the main activity and the service ID that I am displaying in my service should be different. So let us see whether it is different. Let me run this code. As you can see, the main activity thread ID is 1, and I will start the service. On click of that particular button, onStart command will execute, and you can see that thread ID is also 1. So when I say background, it basically means it doesn't have the UI. It doesn't mean by default service always runs on a different thread. If you are doing any long running task in the service, and if you don't make sure that you don't run it on a separate thread by spawning a thread, then you will end up getting an application not responding error. I will put another log statement here to show you how the service gets stopped. Let me rerun this. I'll start the service, and you can also see you are also getting the log output as service destroyed. That's because I have written this stop cell. If I remove this and rerun it, start service, and you can see that the service is not stopping at all. So you have to stop the service from inside the service. You cannot stop the service from anywhere else. So that is why writing a stop cell becomes very, very important. You can observe that this particular onStart command returns a integer variable. It basically returns a kind of flag which determines the behavior of the service. And also I have got method called onBind, which I have not talked about. These come into picture when I am talking about a bound service. In the next video, I will be talking about what do you mean by bound service, in which case you will be using this, and what is the behavior determined by the flag that is being returned in this particular onStart command method. So stay tuned to the channel. Let me know what new things you want to learn in this particular channel. If you have got any doubts, please write them in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.